ask that? Where the cash in the middle? Boy, I just solved the riddle for this pound cake. Giggles, now I see fiddle all around me. He little, my head was on a swivel. He was pushing a rental. Ain't it coincidental? He ain't really talking money. Who he talking to? Homie, hop it. Need a they awesome. I can charge a band to get a glimpse of what I'm about to do. They be talking to every about what they ought to do. Yeah, I ain't tripping off of nothing. My name is topic discussion. If I give them attention, they all would probably start blushing. So power and honey is the only thing that I'm crushing on. Bonafide, stood on everything that I stepped on. I can get it gone in a blink. We can make a from the safe. He can make a call if you tweet.
Black money.
I can make a ball when I speak.
Rap money.
Brother used to hide a hundred. The hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty tryna come up on the bands cause of that. We don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the cash at?
They couldn't see me coming with binoculars. Even if they did, tell me who the f*** was stopping us. The options keep popping up. Cops trying to lock us up. When it's out the picture, but it ain't no Diddy cropping this. Sorry, officer, I'm a hood philosopher. In the open all the chakras up the block inside it and molten lava. Check your thermometers. These rats is anonymous. The climate's in Guatemala, bro. Bet your bottom dollar your favorite rapper to get devoured. Sign his death certificate quick. Like sayonara, in fact, spread it if he quit and save himself a problem. He ain't got a chance to solve him. Tell me, get him any.
Gone in a blink.
Stack money.
We can make a from the same.
Money.
He can make a call if you tweet.
Black money.
I can make a ball when I speak.
Rap money.
Brother used to hide a hundred. The hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty tryna come up on the bands cause of that. We don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the cash at?
First off, my name told, but it's really Tobe Chuku. Got a BM that keep my season, that keep me fufu. Grew up wearing platinum fubu on the Southwest eating fufu. And a hammer that I keep don't come with nails. That nails. Look, I ain't know who Bill Burr was until I met the man. Half my married to the street without a wedding band. I done peeped at all the these rappers won't be secondhand. My pop said I'd be broke and barely eat. I should've bet the man. Yeah, cause I'm way, way, way up. Long ways from the days I'd evade valet stores. Couldn't pay nowadays. All the cake I make us is enough to buy about 100 trucks from Mercedes. I resage Chuku is it. Then my babies. Label hit be trying to sway me. Sway me. Pay me. Wrote the game 2020. You can see it plainly. Can't nobody play me. I kill everything innately. At the helm of the mothership of drip. You can see me leaking. Be quiet, a real speaking voice of God. Every word I jot, feel the spirit breathing. Best new artist, but the way I cook, very seasoned. Everything around me moving, like bachata. Usher told me do it my way, Frank Sinatra. Been a shot to been locked in with my katas. Now I got them raving how I'm big on lines. I love the night. Sheesh. Home guard, I'm a dog, bro. Need a clergy collar, dodge and fleas from you, dog. Adversely, I affect a demon with this God flow. Then put my queen in yellow, bravo. Yeah, we on baby number quattro. Yeah, my whole crib look like an art show. Yeah, pockets on avocado. I'm like a bird, let me fly away. Nelly Furtado, bye.
If I did it, then I did it right.
Yes.
Yeah. This ain't happened for me overnight.
No.
Yeah. Bet against me, you gon' pay the price. Yeah. Down to business, I ain't playing nice.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to historic Baltimore, Maryland and M&T Bank Stadium. Today we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here, as it'll be the Washington Commanders taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Set to go now in Week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. he'll start this drive out on the ground. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down. Well, this defense for the Ravens, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw?
He's got a man complete. Big yardage that time for Washington. 56 yards.
What my dad would say sometimes, I'm just scratching my head here trying to figure out what was going on there defensively. How did you lose him in the middle of the field? If you're going to lose a receiver, make sure it's someone on the short side of things, not deep downfield, that can hurt your defense.
So that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Howell. He finds his man, complete. That's Ellis. Touchdown, Washington. A great effort there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Commanders are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. But 3 plays already in the end zone. That was quick.
We always talk about offenses understanding what they want to do before they go into a game, and they practice it. They have their script and the plays they want to open with. But defenses aren't just reactive. They have their own ideas as well. These ideas didn't get implemented very well. 3 plays and a touchdown already scored against them.
Kick team out there for the Commanders as they send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 26. Are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. So already trailing, Charles, they opted to try to take a shot on their first play from scrimmage. Obviously, that one didn't pan out.
Absolutely not. And how about the momentum that's being created now? You score, you take it away, big return. You've got a chance to go up 2 touchdowns here early in the game. That'll feel great for their team.
To the 36-yard line, stop there. You know, look at this Baltimore defense. They were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, do you now decide that I can't throw the ball against this team and try and run it like crazy? Or do you challenge them? This is going to be fun.
Line of scrimmage, the 36 on 2nd and 8. To throw. Howell. There goes a deep ball. End zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. 36 yards. And the Commanders are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. They've got to be thrilled on the road right now. Touchdown, turnover, touchdown, and quickly trying to make it 14-0.
Yeah, and mentioned it already. On the road, to be able to go into someone else's house and establish a start like that, obviously your confidence rises in a big way, and you're putting some doubt in their minds.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So, decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Again, they'll run. This is McGee. And he gets this one just shy of the 40 down at the 30. 12 yards to come back there. Good for him. And first, play-by-play because you don't know whether he handed it off or kept it.
Makes you focus, doesn't he? You've got to try and stay with it, and even when we do, we often can get it wrong because our eyes naturally go to him because he creates big plays. If you're a runner and you're playing with Lamar Jackson, aren't you happy? He creates so much concentration on him, it should open up things for you.
And now Jackson will look to throw it. Oh, his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And the Commanders will have solid field position here as they take over at their 45-yard line. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They'll start following the interception in great field position at the 45. A run there on first down and a pretty good one of 5 yards, so make it second and 5.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync, and the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
Here's a second and 5. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. And look at this defense. They were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
And all defensive teams that I know talk about creating turnovers. Takeaways, they call them. And anytime you can get two or more in a game, you've had a really, really good performance. They exceeded that number in a big way.
They come up now, third and 5, following the incomplete pass. And Howell will throw it. Pass taken over. It's been tied in. And he's going to have a Commander's first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
Powell to the air on first and 10. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. He's got it. Touchdown, Commanders. A great effort there. With his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Commanders take a 3-touchdown lead. Boy, still in the first quarter, and look out. I mean, they are on pace for over 80 points in this game. I don't know that they'll get there, CD, but this has been impressive to watch so far.
That certainly would be history in the making, wouldn't it, partner? I'm glad we're here to actually watch and see if it actually happens, although, like you, I have my doubts, but they are firmly in control of this game.
So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away. This taken in right around the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. 2 drives, 2 interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. It's putting the game in jeopardy.
And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. It's going to be a gain of 6 on the keeper, but it leads to a third down.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it, and while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he will have a Ravens first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
against a team coming off a win just as your team did the previous week. You talk about being physical all game long. Sometimes being physical is just being on the spot and helping force the incompletion.
And this may be a carbon copy as he'll again be stopped right at the line of scrimmage.
It's third and 10.
Play action. It's Jackson. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first. Move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and 5. From the gun, Jackson. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. That one good for 17 yards on fourth. Couldn't ask for much more from your offense there. First down. Throwing is Jackson. And he's gonna go down. He sacked back at the 24. After the sack here, second and 11. Now it's Jackson. That's caught. It's Flowers. Touchdown. Zay Flowers. 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Ravens are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on.
So they'll go ahead and accept the penalty.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. They'll start this drive out on the ground. Just shy of the 40. 43 yards rushing for him now on just his first three carries.
Muscle damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've run the belt three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll take this one down to about the 40.
Ball on the 40 now. Here's second and 9.
Brings up second and 9.
Powell. First mistake for him in the ball game as it's intercepted. Picked off by Odafe Owe. Down the right sideline. And he will bring this back. It's a quick 6-yard Raven touchdown.
Charles, he was looking for just a short throw. Kept it in range for the rare linebacker pick 6.
And give him full credit for his focus. He just kept the quarterback in his sights, and where he was looking to throw, he positioned himself perfectly to be there for the interception. He made the play of the game for his defense right there.
The extra point, and good ball. Back with a touchdown at 21-14. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This fielded right at the goal line. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And a great return. Solid field position. He's up all the way to the 45-yard line.
Now that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll.
Well, partner, fast forward with me for a second. Remember, next week they have the open week, so they're going to get some extended rest. Does that change how they manage the rest of this one?
I think it does a little bit, but not by too much, because you're right. You get the extra rest, you get a chance to heal up and kind of heal, do a little bit of a reset for this team. But it's also 7 extra days to think back to the last time you were on the field. So now, a little more importance on what they're getting done, because they carry it with them for essentially 2 weeks.
And now a throw in first down there, but it's incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Second down throw for Howell. Goes down. The Ravens able to get to him.
Traditionally, as a defense, stop the run. But in today's football, it's impacting the opposing quarterback. Make him uncomfortable. And so far, they've not been able to do that.
Not at all. He's been really comfortable in the pocket. 3 touchdown passes already.
So that could be an important first sack if they do want to turn things around.
Continues. Here's another interception. Picked off by Jalen Arthur Davis. And the Ravens are going to have it here just past the 25. And that now 2 interceptions thrown in the second quarter.
And you know, a lot of people look at these guys and they think to themselves that maybe, possibly, they're still thinking about the first one. And they probably are. I think in this case, he's just trying to atone for the first interception. Tried a little bit too hard, maybe forced it a bit, and instead created a second one.
First down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be second down.
Oh, there's plenty of traffic waiting for him up the middle. But give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
Here's McGee. And he powers his way up past the 30. Here is 3rd and 5. Now it's Jackson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Ravens at 3-2, a game over 500 here to start the season. They come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victory, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks. Give him a yard up to the 42. They work now on 2nd and 9. They go play action with Jackson. And this is going to be pulled in by the tight end Andrews. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 27 yards there, a first down.
Kind of a dangerous throw there. He's off balance when he gets rid of it. But this is all about a quarterback knowing what he can get away with. And that time, it turns into a completion and a healthy gain as well.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Jackson to the right side into the hands of Flowers, and they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Ball game. Aubrey
good with a PAT. And he's going to tie up the game as we approach halftime. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kicks away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble, bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Here's second and 10. The shotgun. Here's a diving catch right side. 15 yards the pickup. First down, Washington. Howell trying to get his offense to hurry up and get set. Howell throwing on first down here. He finds his man complete. It's Bradley.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and it'll be second down.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup if someone trying to cover them. It looks like there's one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
The Washington passing game dialed in now. It's a first down.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Throwing that first down, and this one winds up to be incomplete. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
It's Howell with another throw. He finds his man complete. That's Ellis. But he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Good work after the catch. Gets him 15 and a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
On first down, Howell. Looking outside and he's got a man. That's Ellis. Now Washington going to use the second of their 3 timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he maneuvers his way down on the 3-yard line. Now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout.
And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
They've been in the red zone 3 times in this game and have not scored a single point. Can they break through here on second and goal? Throwing here, Howell. Back in the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed.
big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Here's Howell. And this is taken in for a Washington touchdown.
A great play there in the final seconds of the first half.
And the Commanders have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. Extra point right down the middle, and they will take a 7-point lead.
Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter 3?
And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. They'll run with McGee.
And he'll take this to the 32, a gain of about 3. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The heavy set out there. 3 tight ends in the formation for 3rd and 3.
Here's Jackson to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening drive of the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it. And that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion and, more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
On 4th down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. On the return, Jackson. A 41-yard punt, 9 on the return.
And it will be Washington football now with a 1st and 10.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They have played so strongly. You look at the scoreboard, you probably, with the way they played, you would think the margin would be a lot bigger, right?
You would. And in your experience, how many times have we run into coaches where they've talked about, hey, we just want to put it in the hands of our defense and have them win the game? In this case,
yeah, not the case.
Not at all. You want to put it in the hands of your offense, but you always feel better about seeing defense because you think defense is a constant and offense kind of comes and goes. Today, this game, no, they need their offense to stay on a really hot level.
They've been hot so far. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Here's third and nine. In the victory last week as he sends this one away. This will be fielded at the 17, and he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Call that a 46-yard punt, though they did get nine back on the return. And the Ravens, they'll take over. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. To throw is Jackson. This ball tipped, and it's going to be incomplete. Fortunate maybe to get that back. It's third down.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Jackson. Contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. The Ravens send their punter out now as he'll kick it away for the second time. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And the Commanders will take over with a first and 10. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
This second and four. They'll keep it on the ground. Spencer. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. 83 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. We often give credit to the O-line there. Two tight end formation. Those tight ends block pretty well also.
Yeah, and that's one of the most dynamic positions in football now. The tight ends who can block at the line of scrimmage at the point of attack, and they can also get downfield and catch the football.
On first down, it's Spencer down inside the 40.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
From the 39-yard line, here comes second down at 6. This time they'll throw it with Howell. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Back to the and his fifth sack of the season.
That sack didn't quite have the splash of his pick six from earlier. You know he's thrilled to be making big plays during a great individual effort today.
How to approach this. Third down and 16 yards to go. from the gun. He'll take a shot for the end zone.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. A big play there with an amazing diving catch.
And the Commanders have taken a 2-touchdown lead now.
And with the rules as touchy as they can be, it's so hard to complete a diving catch in the end zone, but he just did it pretty well.
How about him getting his body, his hands, everything underneath and around the football without it hitting the ground and causing some doubt in the minds of the people who have to look at this and possibly review it. What a tremendous effort and a great catch.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs. Because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they're not screwing together. Nice drive. They helped themselves out.
Call that a very strong gain of 24.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
Now one into the hands of Flowers.
And they wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Jackson now. Touchdown from 17 yards out,
and the Ravens are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. The extra point up and good by Aubrey.
That cut the lead down to touchdown.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line.
Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And he'll go out of bounds, but 10 yards inside of enemy territory at the 40.
Slot man in motion right. They'll fake it on the jet sweep, but instead a handoff up the middle. And he finds some way to turn this into positive yardage as he struggles forward for a pickup of about 2.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
From the 38 now, here comes 2nd and 8. And how will throw it?
Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Howell throwing on 3rd down here.
And that's incomplete.
Here's Ryan.
And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And it feels like the momentum has shifted. They scored, then their defense forces that last punt. And now a chance to tie the game on this possession. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On second down, Jackson. And he cannot avoid the pressure as the Washington pass rush gets home. No surprise there. Chase Young wrecks that play with a sack.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Here's Jackson on third and long. He finds his man complete. That's Reed. And he will have the Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll try the right side with Harris. And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and ten. Now Jackson. He finds his man complete. It's Phillips. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45. First target, first catch, and a first down.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
This is McGee. They juked him. And he carries this one past the midfield stripe and into commander territory. And quickly, they get to the line. Now it's Jackson. A short throw caught by Andrews. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the tree. Wins the game there on the catch and run. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. On the carry, McGee. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18.
Second and 7.
Here's Jackson. Touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. We are tied here in the fourth quarter.
Now this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. Now, some good hard running there as he'll push his way forward for about 5.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up 5, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
On second down. It's Bradley, and he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Getting down to the good stuff, all tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports.
Well, this crowd into it now. Third and two. Out of the gun, it's Howell. Here's Ryan Stonehouse now as he's on to punt for Washington. That'll be a 47-yard punt, officially 5 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. They'll come up 1st and 10 here. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Right of time. All 3 timeouts still remain. Here's 1st and 10 now. Throwing. Jackson. And a quick throw here. That's complete. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now you got to the check down, a nice, safe throw and a good one.
Jackson. That's taken in by Duvernay. The Ravens going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the 4th. At the 46-yard line. 2nd and 6 coming up. Here's Jackson. Washington now going to use the 1st of their 3 timeouts as he'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Boy, here's a big one. You can just feel it. This is 3rd down now.
That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on 3rd down.
So since that last play got nothing, they'll go ahead and decline the penalty, and that forces a 4th down situation.
The Ravens send their punter out now as he'll come on to kick this one away. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards.
And it will be 1st and 10 as they take over. Here's 1st and 10. Here's Howell.
That is caught by Fountain.
The Commanders going to use the 2nd of their timeouts
as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game.
Now this offense still has the 1 timeout here, remember. 1st and 10. Powell to throw.
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
Second recap real quick. He had the touchdown. And that comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it. He's had himself.
shotgun. The throw left sideline falls incomplete.
The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's thrown it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions. And that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well.
If the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And they will play it safe here and bring this one out to the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And everyone knows the OT rules, Charles, but pretty simple formula. They go down and get a field goal, we continue play, but if they can find the end zone on this possession, ball game over.
And as meticulous as all teams plan for a game, I don't doubt for a second on that offense coordinator's play sheet, he's got some overtime plays that he wants to run. I know it sounds crazy, but they plan for everything. First and 10 all the way throughout the game, second and 7, whatever. Right now, he's looking at that play sheet saying, if we get to overtime, what can we break out that they haven't seen?
On second down, here's the option. And he's going to have a Ravens first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
They go with the ground game, pick up the first, now in plus territory.
And that changes the whole mentality of the play caller, doesn't it? Once they cross the 50, they feel like they're in the strike zone, right? You don't have to be in the red zone to take those big shots downfield or go after the end zone. Right now, that might be available to them.
And now this first drive in OT continues.
We'll play only the one overtime here. If time runs out, it'll be a tie as they come up on second down.
4 yards there on the keeper, but still going to bring up a third down.
But if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
A looking deep here for Flowers.
And he's into the end zone for the touchdown and the game-winner in OT. So the game-winning touchdown came through the air in overtime. Four quarters wasn't enough. We were treated to a really good one,
that we were. I just love being able to be witness to a game like this. All the way through, who's going to win it? We're getting overtime. Great for us. A lot of tension on the field. Very tough. Not a surprise it ended with a passing touchdown. That's the way we play in the NFL. But the execution was pretty darn good.
So for Baltimore, their good start continues as they get their record up to 4-2. And they'll get to stay home again next week.
Meanwhile, for the Commanders, the loss here will move them back to 500 at 3-3.
And now they'll head to the bye week as they'll be back in action in week 8. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden, saying so long, everybody.